click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, welcome back to the subject of Machine Design 1. We are right now learning about those equipments which are undergoing the fluctuating loads. In the last session of this particular topic, we are coming close to certain criteria which are very important in designing and in determining those design aspects. Some of the design criteria that we are going to look at today are Soderberg and Goodman criteria. So let us begin with them. So students, what we know so far is, in case of the fluctuating loads, there can exist either mean stress and amplitude stress. They may coexist together or separately. We know that they both are the functions of maximum and minimum loads. Because of the variations in loads, one extremity is at maximum, another one at minimum, they will exist altogether or separately. In case of that, if there is an alternating load with the mean stress, in that case, the effect on fatigue failure will be observed. Of course, these are the experimentation or experimental outcomes on which we need to decide certain aspects. What did they do is, they performed those experiments, they came up with the values, outcomes, and then they plotted the values. So plot is obtained through the test data. Now, there are two important things that we need to understand. If the loading is completely static, that means there is no variation, in that case, the amplitude stress will be equal to zero because there is no variation that is happening. So amplitude stress has to be equal to zero. So in that case, failure criteria will be completely based on either the ultimate stress or the yield stress. Thereafter, the second thing is, when it is purely reversing stress, stresses are reversing in nature, maybe in tensile and compressive, in a cycle, that is stress cycle, sinusoidal wave, in that case, the mean stress will equal to be zero. And in that case, failure criteria will be purely based on the endurance limit, that is sigma E. Either the endurance limit or the corrected endurance limit that we represent at sigma E dash. Further, let us say sigma A, which is your amplitude stress, is plotted on x-axis and mean stress that is plotted on axis. Now, based on that, the plot can be seen in upcoming slide, of course, but there are a few important things that we need to understand again. For various combinations of mean stress and the axial stress, such failure points are plotted. Now, these points were plotted all together for multiple readings, all together considering for minimum stress, maximum stress, that gives us the amplitude one and the mean stress. Then, few theories were proposed based on this particular failure regions. Very first thing that we need to understand is, wherever those are the points plotted, they represent the failure region. So, all those points, when segregated, the remaining part will be the safe region and the rest of the part will be unsafe region where failure is actually happening. So students, the plot looks like this, where, let me repeat, the mean stress is plotted on x-axis and the amplitude stress is plotted on y-axis. In such case, it was observed that, now let us determine the safe limit, very safe limit first of all, is the yield stress. Because on both the axes, these are nothing but the stresses. Yield stress in one of the cases will plot here on x-axis and on the second case on y-axis. So the line connecting both these values, of course, these two segments are equal in length. In that case, this has to be considered as the safe value or safe design region. In that case, different points were plotted for sigma minimum, that is sigma mean and sigma amplitude, and such points were plotted and they are called failure points. All such points are shown by black dots. Then we can say that these points will divide the given plot into two parts, the unsafe region out of this part and the safe region below this part. Now, to divide it properly, there were different theories proposed, and those theories are represented here in terms of different lines. So let us go one by one through those theories, which are very interesting things in this case. Let's consider the very basic line, which actually fits this failure points optimum wise. That means it may pass through some of the failure points, or it may avoid some of the failure points, so that it tries to balance the failure points. Such a curve obtained was found to be parabolic in nature. We can see that the curve connects the endurance limit point here with the ultimate tensile strength point here. And such a line obtained was called Gerber line. Now this line is used as one of the criteria, because by Gerber's equation or Gerber's criteria, it says that the failure points should be adjusted in such a way that they will be passing through the optimum solution. Let's consider the second line. The second line, which connects again the yield strength with the endurance limit. In that case, the line nature is straight. Unlike the previous line, the line nature here is a straight line. So the only difference is the straight line and parabolic in nature. In this case also, it avoids all the failure points. That means all the failure points are lying outside this particular line. In short, this straight line is dividing the safe and unsafe region very clearly with respect to a line. The earlier line was dividing it with respect to a curve. Such a line obtained is called Goodman's line, because it is based on the Goodman's criteria. The third line, which was obtained, which connects the endurance limit point with the yield stress point, is again a straight line. Now, if you see this properly, this line is a very simple line which avoids all the failure points drastically. So no failure point comes inside this particular curve, which is a straight line in our case. And that's why the line was called as Soderberg line, because it is proposed by the Soderberg criteria. So this is how, for this plot, which is sigma m versus sigma a, we have obtained two regions, failure regions and safe region. And this failure region and safe region were divided into two parts by means of certain criteria. The first criteria we obtained was Gerber line, the second one was Goodman line, and the third one was Soderberg line. It was found that for majority of the cases, the best line that was suited was Goodman line. And that's why for most of the examples, the Goodman line criteria is used for solving the fluctuating load problems. Let me quickly revise that. This particular curve, which is parabolic in nature, it fits those failure points in best optimum way. It may pass some of the points, it may include some of the points, it may not include some of the points. The next one is the Goodman line, which excludes all the points, but the only case is it's a straight line and it connects the endurance limit with the ultimate point. The third one is Soderberg's line, which again is a straight line, but it connects the endurance limit with the yield strength. So naturally, this line falls under the safest region, and that's why we did not even consider the yield stress as the failure criteria, because ultimately for Soderberg line, if you are following that criteria, the design is going to be safe in all the cases. Let's move ahead and look at this particular criteria in different manner. We have a very small comparison through certain points. The very first is Gerber line or Gerber criteria, which says that line, which is a parabolic curve that joins the endurance limit with the yield stress limit. Whereas in Soderberg, it is a straight line and it joins the endurance limit with the yield point. In case of Goodman criteria, it is again straight line, but this time it joins sigma e, that is, in case of Goodman criteria, it is a straight line again which joins the endurance limit point with the ultimate strength point. The second point to think about is the curve fits failure points in best possible way, like we have discussed this earlier. In case of Soderberg criteria, it reflects the conservative approach which lies within the yield region completely. That's why the design done with this has to be safe all the time. The next one is the Goodman criteria, and the line lies beneath the failure points. So it excludes the failure points, and it's safe also is. The third points let me discuss are the equations. The equations obtained, of course, the obtaining of equation or the derivation is not part of our scope, but let us look at these equations. The equation of the Gerbel's criteria, which is a parabolic curve in nature, is given in terms of this particular expression. Let me explain you the main points. Sigma m lies as the mean stress at certain point. Sigma ut means the ultimate strength or ultimate yield strength of that particular point or particular material. Sigma a for that particular point is the average point or amplitude point to be precise, and sigma e is the endurance limit. If you see, the order is given 2, and that's why it comes out with the parabolic curve, where sigma m and sigma a are the variables, where sigma ut and sigma e are the constant values for that particular material. The next equation is for Söderberg. The parameters are again the same, they are repeated. So here it's just the sigma m divided by sigma ut. Instead of sigma ut, it is sigma yt, because this curve particularly connects the sigma e with sigma yt. Here also it is sigma amplitude divided by sigma e, which is endurance limit. If you see, the degree of this equation is 1, where again these two are the constant values and these two are the unknown values or variable values. In case of Goodman criteria, it is again a straight line, and the equation is very simple, where it is the mean stress and this is the amplitude stress, whereas this is the ultimate strength and the endurance limit. Again, these two are the constant and these two are the variables. So this is how the equations were proposed for these different criterias. Now what we need to do is, whenever a problem of fluctuating load is given, and if we are supposed to use any of these criterias, we need to mention those criterias. That means we need to use their logic, and accordingly the appropriate equation will be used to find the unknown stresses at certain point, at particular point. Let us arrive at the conclusion point of this particular small topic. Goodman criteria, like I said, is preferred, and there are certain reasons. The reasons are, the line is completely inside the failure data. There is no failure point included in this line. That's why it has to be a safe design criteria. The second one is, the line equation is simple and compared to the parabolic curve. We have seen that the equation is very straight line equation, and which is quite simple than the parabolic curve, and hence solving the equation becomes little easy as compared to the parabolic curve. Third point that we can say, a scale diagram is not necessary for any simple iteration or illustration. Because the line nature is straight, we can draw an appropriate diagram. Need not to be scaled in nature, because the values are in arithmetic progression, which we can solve very easily. And that's why, because of these reasons, Goodman criteria has an upper hand as compared to the remaining two criterias. One thing to be noted, that Söderberg criteria also is safe, but it over-designed the given product, because it lies within the safe region completely, and that's why it is used the Goodman criteria for the design against fluctuating loads. So this was from my side in this session. Into tomorrow's session, we'll be looking at different aspects when the combined loading comes into picture and how to design them, which are the formula to be used. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to Ikeda.